Mermaids, it's Marielle from Aqua Mermaid, and today I'm doing a review of the new live musical of The Little Mermaid. And I'm super excited because this just came out a few days ago and I want to give you my opinion about it. It's mainly a new version. It's a mix of The Little Mermaid movie from Disney made in 1989. But also with live music acts, with real performers, and also puppetry. And also, I made a playlist for you of 5 songs that are completely the show online. And then you can watch them and have a fun time with it. And it's made by ABC Network. You will see the critics are a bit harsh online, but here is my opinion according what I've seen from online. I was not there in person, but I found some great footage to share with you what it looks like. Then it starts with Jodie Benson, the original Ariel voice in the Mermaid movie in 1989, and she's welcoming everyone and she does it perfectly. It's great to have her on the show, and she's opening it to bring it to the Under the Sea song. And that's a big song in the movie. A lot of colors, a lot of under the sea creatures dancing and singing, and I was expecting a lot. For this, I think the costumes are really nice. Favorite part was some jellyfish chandeliers with Aerialists dancing inside them, and also there was little starfish at the back doing some backflips and dancing, and that was really nice. Everything in the air to make it really like in the water. People are floating, flying. There was a lot of puppets that were dancing, singing, and also people in different costumes like turtles, stingrays, seahorses, different kind of fishes. Sometimes I was not sure what they were, but they were super happy and they were dancing. I think there was some shrimps, maybe some coral, some clams. What I really like it, they were using a lot of space of the stage. The stage was coming outside within the crowd. Also, they use a lot of immersion, like theater. There was bubbles everywhere going through. Something that struck me is Sebastian. Sebastian was the lead singer for Under the Sea, and I was really disappointed. First for his costume. Mainly Sebastian was wearing a red jacket. There was not even claws, a little lobster. It was like a motocross outfit, or it also looked like Shaggy outfit from the Thriller movie, from the Thriller song, or even Britney Spears' red outfit from Oops, I Did It Again music show. Then I felt that was not the best costume option. It didn't feel like a lobster at all. And also I felt this song was so lively and so happy. And Shaggy, maybe that's the Jamaican side, that yumma and relax, but he was just singing. I think the voice was great, but the energy and the dance was not there for me. Moving on to the next song, we have the best part of the show with Ursula, that was done by Letitia Queen. That was wonderful. The opening was majestic with her costume of octopus that was moving everywhere, and she was so into it. The headpiece was like fantastic, really high, really like how you would imagine it, and it was stable there, and she was dancing, moving like smoothly as a drag queen, owning the stage. And also we saw her acolytes, the heels going around. It was really cool with all the smoke effect going around, and she stole Ariel's voice, and the laugh at the end, the dark laugh of a mean person from Disney. She owned that music, that song, and that was fantastic, I think. Then she had the first outfit that she was in, it static at the beginning, and then she just took it off as her like a cape from a queen, and she walked in with her other outfit that was shiny, leathery black. Then for the Little Mermaid Ariel, the actress was Olly Cravalho, and she, if you also maybe know her from her voice in Moana, then she's not a new princess, but now she's doing Ariel live, and she was beautiful doing this role. She has a beautiful voice, really angelic, also talking, and she's just so light and so innocent as the Little Mermaid. The song Part of Your World, and that they did it beautifully, because in this scene she goes in a grotto and she has stuff everywhere with her, and it's how do you present in the show someone swimming in underwater when really they're on land. And they did it really well. There was bubbles everywhere, bubble machine that were creating this nice ambience. And then she started slowly just singing on the rock. But then the big moment, she started like flying, and she just did those beautiful, graceful movements of swimming in the air. And she don't stay back in the back on the stage. She comes on top of the crowd and she swims around, she sings, and she's so beautiful in that tail outfit that is super flowy in the air. And that was a really high moment for me, just to see her lift in the air. The logistic was really good. She looked really stable, comfortable singing when she was in the air, and they brought her back on a rock like in the movie. And there was flounder around. I think the flounder part was not the best part. I think flounder took a little regime and is now really skinny, also lost his colors. Then for this part, I would say a lot of puppets were looking of lack of intensity, or didn't put enough budget, or I don't know who was making them, but I feel they could have put a bit more energy into all the different costumes instead of like just on Ursula. That was the amazing octopus, but I think everything went into that costume compared to all the little ones around. Now let's talk about Prince Eric and the song Phantom Below. And this is a great scene that they're singing on a boat, and we have sailors dancing away, running everywhere, jumping. There's a lot of action everywhere. What I like is the crowd is involved and everyone was waving a blue fabric like the ocean waves, and that was really dynamic for the show. All the sailors are dancing and singing, and you see people coming from the sky holding on nets and just flying around. And then Prince Eric arrives holding a rope and just strongly entering the scene, and then he walks and sings and talks to people around him. A really great moment of that song was when Bagel the shepherd dog came in, like in the movie. This dog was just so beautiful, and I think he stole a bit of that show from Prince Eric, because he was so cute and just perfect like in the movie. The last main character is Chef Louis, the chef that is cooking fishes and different crabs. I didn't remember too much that character, but mainly he's doing this big scene of he's cooking some fish and some crab. And for this one, the crab outfits are fantastic. They're really big, they have all those legs around, and they want to make soup, and they are showing how they salt and season all the fishes. And I like how they use the word poisson in French for fish, and just cooking this great food. And you see how the animals were like, oh my god, I'm gonna be eaten. They're so scared, but it's a great song. I like all the chefs and the people in the kitchen had great expression. They were really moving all around, going toward the crowd, back. I like the big pot at the end that all the chefs are inside the big cooking pot at the back. Then I thought they did really well to use this space, and a lot of people are on the stage. It's moving from everywhere. For the production in general, there was a lot of video from the original movie, and I felt not enough of scene where it's live. Also, they were putting on the screen when there was video, like until there will be like 2 minutes before the next live action show. And that made it really weird, because people are just waiting for the show performance. They can watch the movie back home. And that felt a little bit weird as the show. But also the crowd was really involved also during the cooking show. The song with Chef Louis, the cooking, all the crowd was wearing clamps in their hands and just dancing around, and everyone had little clamps in their hands, and then Shaggy the lobster had just bare hands. Then that sounded a bit weird too. Then as a little summary, I think it's fantastic they bring more mermaids into the musical and the shows, but this is just the beginning, because Disney is making a new mermaid live movie. And this is coming for next year, but mainly it's different actors. It's gonna be a full movie with real people in it. And I'm super excited to see how they're gonna make it. Is it gonna be all digitalized, or are they gonna be real costumes of mermaids underwater? Then let's see what's coming up with this. Then let me know in your comment below, what did you think of that show? Did you see it? Or go check my list below that I made for you to watch those videos. And I will stay tuned for all the news with The Little Mermaid. Take care, and I will see you in my next video. Bye! Make sure to subscribe!